Namo Amitabha Buddha. Hello everyone. So today I feel like sharing the story of Master Yongming Yanshou. Master Yongming Yanshou is the sixth patriarch of Chinese Pure Land Buddhism. So December is quite a special month in Chinese Pure Land Buddhism. This is because last week we just celebrated the birthday of Amitabha Buddha, which is on the 17th day of the 11th lunar month. And for this year, it falls on the 20th of December. And some people may ask, why Amitabha Buddha has a birthday? What's the origin of this birthday? So in Chinese Pure Land Buddhism, we set the day of Master Yongming Yanshou's birthday as the birthday of Amitabha Buddha, because Master Yongming Yanshou is also officially recognized as the incarnation of Amitabha Buddha on earth. So amongst all the 13 Pure Land patriarchs, there are two Pure Land patriarchs that are commonly recognized as the incarnation of Amitabha Buddha. The first, we all know, is the second patriarch of Chinese Pure Land Buddhism, Master Shanda. And another one is the sixth patriarch of Master Yongming Yanshou. So what's so special about Master Yongming Yanshou is that not only he is the sixth patriarch of Chinese Pure Land Buddhism, he is also the third patriarch of the Fa Yan School. So Fa Yan School is one of the Chan schools. So he's both a Chan master and a Pure Land master. He first came down to be a Chan master because at that time Chan was the most popular, and then later he told people to kneel for and seek rebirth to the Pure Land. And that's why also in China, in many Chan schools, we see that Chan and Pure Land are practiced together. In fact, in all other Mahayana schools, regardless of what practices you practice, they will also add on the Near Fall practice to seek rebirth to Amitabha Buddha's Pure Land. So the name of Master Yongming Yanshou literally means infinite light and infinite life. So Yongming means forever light, infinite light. Yanshou means extended life, infinite life. So his name already revealed that he is actually Amitabha Buddha. And Master Yongming Yanshou was born in the year 904. And since a young age, he already dedicated himself into studying the Buddha Dharma, and he would even recite the Lotus Sutra. He wanted to take the monastic life at a young age, but unfortunately his parents did not agree, and he would even write the sutra with his blood, and hopefully his wish would be fulfilled in the future. And then he became a government official, like the position of a tax collector. And what he did during that period was that he would use the taxpayers' money to buy animals such as fish, shrimps, and set their lives free. And later he was discovered that he actually used taxpayers' money, so he was sentenced to death. And the evening before his execution, the emperor at that time, Emperor Wu Yue, he had a dream, and he saw an old man that brought hundreds of thousands of fish and shrimps that came to Emperor Wu Yue and said, "Our lives were saved thanks to the official, the tax collector official. Please set his life free and examine him from his crime." And the emperor woke up and thought the dream was quite weird, and he asked people to check on Master Yongming Yanshou and see whether he was afraid of death. And at the time of execution, Master Yongming Yanshou remained absolutely calm and had absolutely no fear. And the punisher, the executor, felt it was quite weird and asked, "Why are you so calm? Why are you not afraid of death?" And Master Yongming Yanshou simply replied, "Because the money I used was not for my own benefit, but I used it to save many lives. So I was happy that those lives were being saved. And I know when I die, I will go to the Western Pure Land, highest level of the highest grade. So why should I be afraid of anything?" And then the emperor released Master Yongming Yanshou and also admired him and knew that he always had the ambition to take the monastic life. So he ordered him to take the monastic life. And after that, Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo went to the Tiantai Mountain, Guoqing Temple, and be the disciple of the abode there. And when the abode saw him, he knew that this is an important person, and he said, "You have deep karmic connection with Amitabha Buddha. In the future, you will spread the Dharma really well, but unfortunately, I would not have the time to see it." And after Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo took the monastic life, he practiced really diligently. At one time, Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo was Nianfu and he saw Bodhisattva Samadabhadra's lotus that appeared on his hand. And in his heart, he thought, "I really need to settle something. That is whether I should single-heartedly practice in Chan or should all good deeds be transferred to the Pure Land." So he wrote these two options on two papers and he decided to draw lots. And for seven times, each time it shows, the paper says, "All good deeds transferred to the Pure Land, all good deeds go to the Pure Land." And after that, he determined that he would practice all the good deeds, all his cultivation, and transfer the merit towards seeking rebirth to the Pure Land. And in his life, he cultivated really extremely diligently. During the day, he would practice 108 Buddhist practices, such as reciting the sutra, reciting the mantras, paying repentance, expounding the Dharma, etc. And in the evening, he would nianfu, and he did not need to sleep. It was said Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo would nianfu for at least 100,000 times a day. This is really the cultivation of a great, great Dharma master. So you don't need to feel pressured if your cultivation is not like Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo. So don't worry. As long as we nianfu with faith and vow, we can also attain rebirth to Amitabha Buddha's Pure Land. So how do the people knew that he was the incarnation of Amitabha Buddha apart from his extremely impressive cultivation? So it was at one time, Emperor Wu Yue made offerings to 1,000 monks. And then he asked Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo, "Did any sage or Buddhas or Bodhisattvas that came to the offerings?" So during the offering, there were many monks, and then later there was this monk with very long big ears and also in dirty clothes. He walked in and he just sat straight in the middle of the seat that was supposed to be reserved for Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo. And Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo told the emperor, "This long-eared monk was actually the incarnation of the Buddha Dipankara." Later, the emperor found the incarnation of the Buddha Dipankara in a cave, the long-eared monk, and he wanted to prostrate at him. And this Buddha said, "Well, why did Amitabha Buddha like to gossip so much?" So he was referring to Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo. So Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo was in fact the incarnation of Amitabha Buddha. And because the monk's identity was revealed, so he also sat in meditation and left his body. So Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, when they came here to help, they cannot really reveal their identity. If their identities have been revealed, then they have to disappear, because this may disturb people's heart too much and not good for spreading the Dharma. So later, Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo also sought rebirth to the Pure Land by sitting in meditation at the age of 72 and left red legs all over his body. And to memorize Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo, people also built a stupa to put his red legs. And after he entered into Parinirvana and rebirth, there was a monk that came to revere at the stupa every day. And then some people ask, "Why did you come to revere and Master Yong Ming Yuanshuo stupa every day?" And this monk revealed that At one time, he was sick. He was at the time of near death, and he went into the underworld and saw the law of Yama. And he saw that the law of Yama, the governor of the underworld, that would judge people's rebirth based on their karma of where they would go after. And he saw the law of Yama was prostrating at a painting. And the monk was curious and asked, who is this person you are prostrating and why? And the law of Yama said, I prostrated at Master Yong Ming Yan Shou because most of the time all the people after death they will come to me and most of the people will fall into the three evil realms. But Master Yong Ming Yan Shou just straight saw rebirth to the Pure Land on the highest level of the highest grade. I admire him very much, so that's why I prostrated at him. So Master Yong Ming Yan Shou's cultivation is indeed impressive. And he also famously said these verses, with Chan and with Pure Land, it's like a tiger has horns. This person can be the teacher of humans, and in his next life, he can be a Buddha. So which means that if someone understood both Chan and Pure Land, then this person is really knowledgeable and really wise, and he can be the teacher of humans, and in the next life he can definitely be a Buddha. And without Chan but with Pure Land, 10,000 people practice, 10,000 people can go to the Pure Land. So this is also to say how easy the Pure Land Dharma is. It's indeed suitable for people with all kinds of roots and capacities. And he also said, with Chan and no Pure Land, 9 out of 10 will be lost. When negative phenomena appear, the person will go with his karma. So this is saying that it's not easy to practice Chan only. Most likely one will be lost because one cannot realize enlightenment based on a self-effort, and most likely that they have to again reincarnate or even fall into the three evil realms with the karmic force. And the last stanza was, without Chan and without Pure Land, iron bed and copper pillar. And for hundreds of thousands of kapas and lifetimes, one cannot rely on anybody. So if one doesn't practice the Buddha Dharma, then there is no way for one to exit the cycle of reincarnation, and most likely one may fall into the three evil realms due to one's karmic force and to bear sufferings for a tremendously long time there. Although Master Yong Ming Yan Shou also practiced other practices in his life, he still told most people to just mindful single-heartedly and seek rebirth to the Pure Land because he felt people's karma is too heavy and it's not easy to realize enlightenment. Nowadays, in Pure Land School, we recommend people to just single-heartedly practice the mindful practice, the Pure Land Dharma, because it's the easiest for people to seek rebirth to the Pure Land, and is suitable for beings with all kinds of roots and capacities. The Chan practice is still a bit too difficult and even complicated for some people. So if you are a Chan practitioner or the practitioner of other Mahayana schools, then we also recommend you to please also practice the Nyingpo practice with faith and vow towards seeking rebirth to the Pure Land. This will be easiest for you to exit the cycle of reincarnation if you cannot realize enlightenment in one lifetime. And really, most people do not have the ability or the capacity to realize enlightenment in one lifetime. Therefore, regardless of what kind of practices you practice, you should always also mindful with faith and vow to seek rebirth. So this is the same as Master Yong Ming Yan Shou's recommendation for most people, and also Master Shan Da, Master Ying Guang's teachings. So this is in line with all the Pure Land Patriarch's teachings. So may all beings hear the name of Amitabha Buddha and be reborn in the land of ultimate bliss. Namo Amitabha Buddha. Namo Amitabha Buddha.